in things to me are second nature. Whereas there are many people who are dabbling in this or even teaching and writing books who are coming from countries where they can't even own a sharp sword. Isn't that sad? They're not allowed to own a sharp sword. Really makes you appreciate our Second Amendment. Also, sometimes you'll see me holding the sword backwards. Here's something that's kind of neat about this, and this gets to, this subject is still evolving. We're still discovering and still finding out information. We thought that some of the illustrations showing the sword like this were wrong, backwards, particularly when this curves a little bit or is thickened here. We thought, what's going on? It can't be backwards. The artwork was so accurate, how could they do it backwards? Well, then I saw in museums, in private collections, swords like this that were sharpened on this side and not on this side. And that's when we realized that having the blade shaped like that gives more mass to that part and does facilitate certain techniques. And it turns out not to be a mistake. So I'm no longer really concerned, even though this one is only edged on this side, I'm not really concerned how I'm facing it. All right, so if he holds it and it blocks with the edge, what happens with sharp blades is that they dig into the shield. And on a wooden shield, it gets stuck.